Hi friends, my name is Whitney and we're gonna do an intermediate level GRE question today. And specifically a choose all that apply. So take a couple of minutes to work on it before we go over it together. So for story problems, our job is to find a way to get the story onto our paper in some form of mathematical notation. And the default is typically going to be equations. Although I hope that you'll see by the end of this question that default doesn't actually mean preferred way. But if we want to write an equation that relates salesperson A and salesperson B, we see that salesperson A has sold 35% more motorcycles than salesperson B. Now make sure with percents that you're careful of whether you're taking a 35% of or 35% more than. Now algebraically, we would represent this as A equals 1.35B to represent that 35% more. The only other information we're given is the question itself. So what is the total number? Or what would A plus B's total number of motorcycles have turned out to be? Which of these answers are possible? At this stage, you might notice that we have three things that we don't know and only two equations. And so this isn't a simple system of equations we can solve. The best we could do at this point is look at plugging in for A, and we'd have 1.35B plus B, and then maybe we can combine our like terms into 2.35B equals total. But I'll be honest, what to do next doesn't seem entirely intuitive. And this is why algebra can often let us down. And so there are a couple of clues in this problem that tell me not to start with algebra. And the first one is that we've been given a proportion between the two unknowns. And so A is always 35% more than B. The other thing is that we're asked for a total number of something that has to be an integer, so number of motorcycles. So if I'm dealing with proportions and integers, I like to look at things in the format of a ratio. So what I mean by that is that if we were to think in almost like real number terms, the ratio of A to B would be as if B sold 100 motorcycles, A selling 35% more would be 135. That would then put us at a total number of motorcycles in this scenario of 235, which is kind of nice. That's one of our answer choices as a possible total. The question is, are there other possible totals? So crucial rule with ratios is that you always want to get down to the reduced form of a ratio. And since all three items in our ratio are divisible by 5, we're going to divide them all by 5 to reduce. And so you can use your calculator for this, but we'll get the ratio of 27 to 20 and then to 47. And again, that's kind of nice. That's one of our totals that was available. So we'll put a check in that box too. So how do I find out if the other two are possibilities? Well, once I have a reduced ratio, I'm in a really powerful place where by multiplying all three of the items in my ratio by any number I want, I can create additional scenarios of possibilities. And so the first thing I might do is choose the easiest, which would be to just double the ratio. So literally, I'll use a multiplier of 2 and throw that through all of the terms. And so again, feel free to use your calculator if that feels a little safer in this problem. But what we get is, if we double, there would be 54 motorcycles sold by salesperson A, and then we'd have 40 by B, and that would bring us to a total of 94. Notice though that we jumped past the 70 in the answer choices, which means there's no integer way to try and get a total number of motorcycles to be 70. So we can eliminate that. Last, we're trying to test that 135. So we multiplied by 2 already. We'll take that reduced ratio and this time multiply by 3. Since we're pretty close. And so if I multiply through, what I've got is 81 sold by A, 60 sold by B, for a total of 141. And once again, we've moved past that possible number, meaning that we can't get that as a total. And so we can eliminate 135. So with ratios, I think it's a lot more clear to see that our answer is just the first and the last options. Subscribe for more GRE Math Spotlight videos by Manhattan Prep. And then leave us a comment to tell us how you solved this problem. Happy studying!